welcome to my channel, and I hope you're having a great day. My name is Melanie, and today we're going to be doing a feel-good 1 mile walk. So I'm gonna talk about morning routines and maybe some bedtime routines that will make you feel good and just set the mood for a wonderful day and a wonderful week. So let's pop on up. We're gonna use it as kind of like a meditative walk. Set your form, set your intention. Know that you're just getting some movement in your body today. We're not here to beat our bodies up. We're here to embrace it and love it and enjoy it. So inhale those arms up. Exhale, push away those negative thoughts. Inhale those arms up. Exhale, push it away. Two more like that for me. Inhale up. Exhale, one more. Inhale up. Exhale, let's strong, walk strong. So your shoulders are down, your abs are in, you're lifting those feet with purpose. So yes, we're not doing a high intense workout right now, but I want those movements to be purposefully done. So your legs are moving, you're getting those heart racing, some fresh oxygen in your body. And every time you exhale, you breathe out the negative, breathe in the positive. Good, let's hold it here, tighten those tummies. Anything can be a tummy workout. So I want you guys to start thinking about things that you do in the morning that really set your day for a positive, happy, healthy day. So what does my morning routine look like? Maybe different than yours, but I try and wake up every day and do something for myself, something positive, something happy, something to set my mood, because really, we are in control of the mood and the day that we have. It's bigger and purpose, like the air is thick. So I try and sneak up earlier before anybody else does. I'm a morning bird though. So I try and sneak up about an hour early before anybody else does, and I've got my coffee pot going, and I make my smoothie and take all my vitamins. But I also try, whether I do sometimes I'm better at this than others, but I try and do a gratitude journal, whether I do it writing it down or mentally or in email form, or I go online, go ahead and give me a kick, and I find an affirmation, a positive affirmation, go on Pinterest, go on Instagram, whatever it is, and try and find a positive affirmation. And start my day with that. Now, what is not always the best thing to do is scroll the social media pages and the news and different posts on different boards right now, because there's a lot of negativity going on. So I tried to make a promise to myself, really use those arms, you guys, that I would stay off of browsing those types of posts that bring me down. Right? Especially first thing in the morning, drink my coffee, do my gratitude journal, look at positive affirmations, eat a healthy breakfast, start getting ready for the day, laying it, mapping out my workout, what it is that I'm gonna do. Good. We're here for 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, march it out. But it is going to do for my workout. Kind of maybe mentally meal prep. By that time, my house, somebody's waking up. What I'm trying to do with my kids and my husband is trying to get them to say something nice every single morning or every single evening about themselves or about one another. Which is actually hard to make a habit out of. Let's walk forward. 1, 2, 3. So that kind of gets my mood set for the day, and I'm going to be honest, some days it's really easy to do, some days not so easy to do. But especially on those days where it feels harder to kind of get those positive things going, that is when you need it the most. Give me a little kick and back. really force a smile on your face when you're feeling blue. Really pick up a pen and a piece of paper and do some gratitude soul searching when you're feeling blue. And then part of my morning routine is doing my workout. I try and do something almost every morning, but I really listen to my body. Hold it here and push those heels forward, push those arms forward. Right, so I really listen to my body. So in the past, I think I talked about this with you guys in the past, I would, no matter what, overrun, no matter what, do some kind of hit style. These days, I listen to my body, but I try and get some sort of movement in every single day. I aim for 20 minutes, sometimes 10, sometimes an hour. Listen to my body. That's part of my morning routine, and I know sometimes life gets in the way, but and that's why I wake up early to get it done before life gets in the way. But that works for me, it might not work for you guys. If you can't get your workout in first thing in the morning or your movement in first thing in the morning when you first wake up, set aside some time where you'll move. And I know it might not be every day, and I should rephrase that. Some kind of movement every day, whether it's yard work or swimming in the pool or taking a walk. Whatever, some type of movement. Doesn't have to be a workout. Hold it here, keep that through some hips, because why not? Side to side, hips, just feel good. Shake it up, just for a little bit. So now it's not bedtime, right? 5, 4, 3, 2, and march it out. Bedtime gets more stressful, especially if you're a mom. So, try and put down my phone for an hour before I go to bed and listen to music, organize my drawers, do my hair, watch stupid TV. So for me, it's more simple because I just want to shut my mind off and just feel good. So bedtime is an important time for me to not be texting, not be surfing the internet. It's, I get my kids to bed, we bathe, we giggle, we read, and then for me, I like to just shut down, check out for a little bit. So those are some things that kind of get me going with these double steps and make me feel happy and positive. What I would love to hear is what are some of the things that you guys do in the morning and especially at bedtime. I always want to know, especially right now when things are a little bit negative and a little bit crazy and sometimes it feels like we're living in a twilight zone right now. Up, 1, 2, 3, up, 1, 2, 3, up. I'd like to know what kinds of things do you guys do first thing in the morning and right before you go to bed to get your mindset to drown out those negative thoughts, the negative talk. What do you do? I know when I'm feeling sort of out of control, you start comparing yourself to others, start talking yourself down, and now is not the time to do those things. We're gonna hold it stationary. You need some arm circles. Breathe. Arm circles forward. I like to always add my hips. Woo. Something too that makes me feel good, this is sort of midday. Get outside. It's hot right now, it's summer. If you're in Florida, especially, it's hot. Just do something outside. Splash around in the water, get some fresh air other way. The sunshine is so positive and so feeling good. Feel good for your soul. Breathing for 5, 4, 3, 2, and back to those marches. Good, you guys. Let's keep it up for another couple minutes. Just like I said, a little mile walk right here. We're gonna kick, 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 kick. And when you're feeling those negative self-talk, how do you kick them away? Just stop. Stop doing what you're doing and really think about things that you're proud of for yourself, for your family, for the community. Again, because right now you turn on the news, you turn on social media, there might be some negative stuff, so just stop. Stop. And think of things that are positive, again, with yourself, the community is doing so great right now with what's going on. And think of those things. I know it's easier said than done. Believe me, for 4, 3, 2, and 1. And hug the people that live in your house. Force a smile. Force a laugh. And do something to move the body, awaken the soul. Good. March it out. 4, wide march. 3, 2. Never miss an opportunity to do some abs. So hold it here and rotate to the left. 8 times, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Let's go right to the other side. 8 times, 8. So yeah, so today's movement was not made for you to feel sore tomorrow. It was not made to torture your bodies. It's made to make you feel good. Kind of like a meditative walk. So whatever you guys are doing, give me 2 more right here. Give me some side steps, whatever you guys do, some like big arm crosses. We're gonna start winding it down. Whatever you guys are doing right now, whatever you guys are thinking, you should be walking with me. Whatever you guys are thinking, stop. And think of 3 things that you are proud of. Whether it's yourself, family, your community, your home, the way you've been working out, the way you've been taking care of yourself, the way you've been honoring your body with that chocolate chip cookies or that glass of wine every single night. Don't beat yourself up. Honor it. Okay, but stationary and open that chest. So 3 things, you don't have to tell me, or you can share it with me. It's 3 things that you're proud of yourself about. And I'll give you guys 3 things I'm proud of. So, number one, spending some time, more time at home, back to those marches, but now we're just going to wind down the marches. Spending some more time at home with what's going on, I've gotten some opportunity to slow down with my kids, and my 4-year-old is picking up some reading, which is really exciting, and my 3-year-old is shouting up a storm, and I see him doing, like, using his imagination more than if we were out running around doing errands. I really got to focus on different, I guess, I don't know, milestones, but different things, and I'm proud of myself because I set up a good sort of structural plan for them in this time, in this uncertain time. I'm proud of the community because I do see a lot of people coming together, even though there's some differences right now. I see some people coming together and talking each other up, and I'm trying to drown out all the other negative stuff, but I see a lot of people coming together and boosting each other up, especially on this Thy Fitness virtual platform. It's really cool to see everybody meeting goals and boosting each other up. And I have to shout out to the husband. He's working very hard, helping small businesses, so I'm proud of him. And all of his hard work and helping the small businesses thrive. So yeah, sometimes I can feel a little bit uncomfortable to say those things out loud, but it kind of feels good to do that for yourself. All right, you guys, let's give me 1 more deep breath. Inhale up. Exhale down. 2 more. Inhale up. I'm getting called. Exhale down. And 1 more. Exhale down. Thank you guys. I hope you guys like that. Make sure you subscribe and comment below with some things that you do to make your day more positive, more healthy, more happy, and to drown out those negative thoughts. I'd love to hear about it. And think of those 3 things. Have a great day.